Hello.
Hey there.
Let's play for a while people come in.
Thank you.
Hello, hello. Hi, Laura. Oh, you were pedalling fast to get back home. You've been out cycling. Samantha, good to see you. Sarah, hello. Annie and Amy.
Cool.
And all of you who are joining us. Sitting outside with our birds again.
There's a pigeon up there, he's been watching me since I started playing.
Has he?
Yeah.
Maybe he fancies learning the didgeridoo.
Yeah, right.
That'd be nice.
That'd go well, the
pigeonery-doo.
Yeah. I'll have to make him quite a special mouthpiece. Yeah. Wow. Hey, Mama. So, how are you doing today? I was talking this morning to a client, and it really helped crystallize a feeling that I've had around this weekend, around the eclipse energy. So Friday evening with that full moon, there was a lunar eclipse, and then 2 weeks' time we'll have a solar eclipse. So these eclipses always come in patterns, you know, there'll be two or three within a period of time, and they feel like periods of great growth and change. And as always with growth, you know, it's like if your brain a bit too big for your top and it's squeezing you in, it's it's uncomfortable. Till you can unzip it and take it off and then you feel good again. And often these eclipses can be like that. For a few weeks can feel a bit squeezed and things will come up that would be a bit sticky.
I was thinking, sometimes it can feel like for a few weeks, read a few years. But of course, we know really within that there's variance, that sometimes it can feel like it's just never-ending stuff.
Yeah.
But we are in such a massive part of the planet's evolution.
Mm.
You know,
yeah.
We're here in quite a spectacular time.
Mm. Yeah. Yeah, and that's something else actually that's been in my mind is I've been listening to something called the Ra material, the power of one, and they're talking about how 2012 was a shift point and how the phase of evolution that we've entered now, it'll take us about 35 million years to get through, and this first initial stage of the adjustment from the density that we were at into the new density, a few hundred thousand years. That's how long it takes on average in the other planets that have gone through this experience. And it really helped me get perspective on what we're going through. To change that perspective, like you said, you know, like you can feel like years, you know, that we're going through this stuff. And yeah, absolutely, you know, lifetimes.
Mm.
Lifetimes of this. And to know, and this is what material like that really helps me have that different perspective to understand, okay, this is part of that wider thing, that much, much grander scale.
Mm.
And I'm not going to get everything done in this lifetime.
Mm.
I've got time, chill out, enjoy this one, you know, do everything that I want to and everything that I can in this lifetime.
Mm.
But to know the pressure's off. This is, you know, we're part of this eternal evolution and infinite evolution and infinite space.
Mm.
So yeah, just keep doing your best. It's all you can do is keep doing your best.
Yeah, and that reminds me of, I just read Sarah, you've got an urge to clear out stuff again. Yeah, it's like that, isn't it? That happens on all levels.
Yeah.
And when the space that we're in physically is, we can clear that stuff, we tend to feel a lot clearer within ourselves as well.
Mm.
And I'm sure you're experiencing that. It's probably why you've got the urge to clear stuff out, hey? I know I have as well.
Mm.
And I was just thinking then, Ollie, when you were saying about to do your best, it reminds me of that thing that it's such a clear way of saying it, to tune your... like tuning your radio to the station that you want to listen to, and how we can get very sort of muddled by all the different information and wanting to, you know, sometimes that feeling of wanting to go ahead in one direction but not wanting to leave people behind and kind of wanting to make it better for them somehow, or some this kind of mixed message in a way to your body of like moving forward but kind of trying to save people that aren't quite ready to move, or whatever it is, however it turns up for you, that there's this just really, for me, really clear analogy of tuning to the frequency that you want. And you, unless you have like multiple radios on just that one radio, you can only tune to one station, otherwise it's just going to be fuzzy. And it's just really helps me like come back, like, what is it that, you know, as we were saying on Friday, what is it that I want to transmit, and also what do I want to tune into? You know, I'm not going to be able to hear what my neighbour's listening to if I've not got it tuned to the same thing. So if he says to me, oh, that was a really beautiful piece of music, did I hear it? And I'm like, no, I didn't get to hear that because I was listening to Radio 1. Why didn't I get to hear that beautiful cello quartet? It's like, well, I was on a different channel. So it's doing that thing of doing our best to tune into what we actually want for ourselves, and what we want as whenever we talk really for ourselves, it's really for the globe, for the planet. So it's a really nice little reminder that, like, what are you transmitting and what are you tuning into? Because if we're constantly switching channels, it gets very confusing. And if we're kind of trying to please lots of different people as well as ourselves, then it just all gets crackly and full of static, and it's just not very pleasant. So it's like, what do you want to tune to? What do you want to tune into and attune yourself with and transmit? And that can really be the guiding star, really, like really help us when there is so much stuff going on to really keep a clear, even if sometimes it feels like a really narrow path, that there is a path there that we're walking, and it can change any time, of course, but having that consciousness of what is it that we're tuning into. And that's, maybe that's for later. Should we play for that?
Yeah, let's play for that. Hey, Howard, good to see you on. So early morning in Florida. Thanks for joining us.
Oh, you're back in the US.
Yay.
Connecting with the sense of what it is that you want to
Beautiful, Megan, thank you.
So what is it that you are choosing to tune into this week? What are you tuning into today? And you know, sometimes the tuning dial can be, do you remember? I don't even know if that's how radios are anymore. But you see the needle like move up and up and up and up, depending on where you want to be. You can change that needle. Like maybe you can use that as a visual if you want to. And it doesn't matter where you are, what you're listening to just now and what you're tuned into, and how long it takes to tune and finally tune. And then it might go out of tune and then finally tune again. But maybe have an intention for yourself if it feels nice for you, if it feels good for you. Have an awareness of that. An intention for what you're tuning into today and this, maybe this week, maybe this whole week. And keep reminding yourself to tune back in. When you can feel yourself going to that static, just tune back up. And let the environment help you with that, you know, the birds. Maybe you'd even like to share and hear. Whether now or later, maybe you'd like to share what you're wanting to tune to today and this week, so you allow that to be heard and others witness that, and you inspire others with your wish of what you're wanting to tune into. Maybe you want to tune into the joys in life. Or maybe you want to tune into feeling calmer and more able to meet things in a balanced way. Maybe you want to tune into feeling abundant. Share, be generous with your intention so we can share with you and others can share in that and be inspired by you and put energy to yours because yours is ours, you know. Tune into the loving, beautiful, and freedom. Yeah, so I'm just reading Annie's just so I can kind of share with you. I know you can probably be seeing it as well. But it's just reminded me, I think this is what you're talking about as well on Facebook, social media. See how your intention actually starts to show up in what you're seeing as well. And make the choice if there are people posting things that you really don't want to see, that bring you down in some way, then just unfollow them. You don't have to unfriend them, but it just means their posts won't come up on your feed. And start actually inviting more and more of what you want to be tuning into. And notice it turn up in your world in whatever way, whether it's social media or your neighbours or the environment. But yeah, please do keep sharing. Thank you, Annie, for sharing. We'd love to read what you're intending for yourself, for tuning into. And I'm happy to hear from you, Annie, that tuning into us is bliss and a balm. Bliss balm.
Bliss balm.
And we'll see you on Wednesday. Christina, to tune into inner peace.
Nice.
Yeah, good one.
And also you may want to tune into our next Moving into Alignment series. We're starting on the next full moon.
The plan is to start on solstice. It might be a little bit early to get people gathered together, but we're hoping for that.
And so to help people get on board, we've got a super early bird.
Super. Oh yeah, that finishes tonight, folks.
Finishes tonight, so please do go and have a look at the event at soundbathhealing.com on the events page. You'll see our intention and also what other people have said about being on the Moving into Alignment series, the one that's just finished. And I know a couple of you are here with us today. It really is a beautiful journey, a really powerful journey, and we hold you, you know, we hold you in a loving, compassionate space.
Yeah.
Throughout that whole 6 weeks, it's not just about the meetings, it's about that whole time gives you a space to be, to be present with what's going on, and as I was saying before, you know, this is a time of growth and change, so it can really help to have that wider perspective and that wider held space.
And to keep tuning in, just keep tuning in.
Keep tuning in,
I just want to read some of your shares because this is really great. Sarah, you're saying how the stray frequencies suddenly went very faint, mainly related to ambitions. So it's not ambition at all. So I wonder what it is for you, Sarah, what that frequency is. Is it allowing? Something like that. Laura, tuning into gratitude for all the beautiful people and things in my life. Yay, Annie. MIA, it's brilliant. I'm moving into alignment. So, please do keep bringing your intentions. Let that be an inspiration for all of us throughout the day, and maybe it'll keep going throughout the week. And we'll see you again on Wednesday. And if you want to join us for the Moving into Alignment starting on solstice, the super early bird finishes tonight at midnight UK time. So go get yourself a ticket, folks. And if there's any issues, you really want to join us, but you are concerned about financial issues or anything like that, talk to us. We generally have ways of working it out with you to make it possible.
Yeah, we never want money to be a barrier, you know, just please, get in touch and we'll work it out.
We can work it out. We can work it out. So, yeah, wishing you a beautiful day. And we'll see you Wednesday.
Okay, lots of love.
Lots of love.
Bye.